there. Good morning. Well, it's almost afternoon. I hope you guys are having a great day. Thank you. I'm gonna do some Reiki, so sit back, relax, and receive. If you are new here, ooh, 1111. If you are new here, welcome. And my name is Molly with Sunflower Soul Healing. And with energy healing, all you need to do, just go ahead and set your intention, whatever it is that you need today in this moment. And please feel free to share this live with others as it helps to get this out to those who may not otherwise see it, and you never know who could use a little support, encouragement, or energy today. Hello! Hi, Mona from Poland. Amazing. Thank you for being here. All right, let's go ahead and we're going to start with the singing bowl to ground us in. So just take some nice breaths. Root chakra for physical anything, hips and below. That root chakra is the earth element. Helping you to feel grounded, safe, protected, anchored, and in your body. Chakra is all about our survival needs, anything in that physical, our home, job, finances. Feeling safe, protected in our body. Feeling balanced. Just allowing that energy to flow down. rest. Stressed or overwhelmed, grounding your energy, working on that root chakra helps to calm your mind, helps to bring you back to balance, just clearing any stagnant energy there, anything that might be holding you back, or you feel sluggish or stuck, or just releasing that. Let's bring in the tuning fork, root chakra tuning fork. You can just listen to the sound. Thank you, Rock Vision, for sharing. Appreciate you. All right, let's do the singing bowl again, just clearing that root. Bring in some serpentine. Ground our energy. Good morning, Christine. How do you subscribe? Well, it looks like you are a subscriber. Only subscribers can Yeah, yours, because you have the little. If you're wanting to do the upgrade You know, I think if you are already a subscriber, maybe you have to wait until the next month. If you're wanting to do the, where you receive the 20 minute. Yeah, it'll say like under subscriptions, like it'll give you two options. But I think someone said they didn't see it if they were already and see, I can't see it from my end. You have to wait until April. Okay, yeah. Yeah, you might have to do that, which is weird. You would think that, because most, you know, it would just let you kind of, but I guess it doesn't. I don't know. We're gonna move up to that sacral, which is right above the roots, and it's orange in color, and the element is water. Water energy helping us to go with the flow, let go of control, tapping into our creativity. Our passion, feeling inspired. Our joy, abundance. And physical, helping with anything in that reproductive area, bladder, that lower back, helping you to feel supported, helping you to release and let go of any fear you might be carrying there. Energy is that divine feminine, represents our emotions, the moon, the cycles. Just moving that energy down from the sacral to the root, down your legs to your ankles, feet into the earth. We can store a lot of heavier emotions here in our hips. Internalize. Thank you. just allow your body to be soft. Notice if you're holding any tension in that, in your hips or your lower abdominal area. Just kind of let it just soften. Bring in the singing bowl. For that sacral, just clearing any stagnant energy there. Going to do the tuning fork for that sacral. You can listen, notice where you feel it within your body. We're going to bring in the lovely carnelian for that sacral. Our sacral is orange in color. And carnelian is wonderful for that sacral. And we're going to move up to that solar plexus. Thank you so much. Which is in the center of our belly. This is our power center. And the element is fire. Beautiful sun. Vitality. I think I am now on probably, it feels like I think it's been 2 weeks since I've seen the sun. Where are you, son? Energy healing helps to calm, balance, and regulate your nervous system. It helps you to get out of that fight, flight, freeze response into that rest and digest and receive. So it helps to calm your mind and your body. System on our body is out of that state, we are able to heal faster, we are able to, our immune system is stronger. Helps us to be in the present moment. And it helps our mental and emotional state. Area, physical, stomach, spleen, liver, gallbladder. Stressed and worried can affect our digestion, or we can feel it in our belly. Just calming everything down. Mm-hmm. energy healing, you can watch me, you can watch, close your eyes, you can listen, whatever feels good to you. The solar plexus is all about our confidence, feeling worthy, our self-esteem, our boundaries. And then this would also be that mid-back area as well. Any tension that you might hold there. That solar plexus, infusing your energy with that beautiful golden light, that warmth. Solar plexus tuning fork, just clearing that even more, balancing it. Bring in some lovely citrine for that solar plexus. Citrine is one of the best crystals for abundance, prosperity. Some pyrite, that golden share. Appreciate it. Lovely. Thanks, guys. Thank you. Thanks, Daniel. Thanks for the roses. Thanks for the shares. I'm going to get a sip of water here. And we're going to move up to that heart space, that heart chakra. So just drop your shoulders. You can even fold those shoulders back, open. Open that heart chest area. And just helping to release any stress, heaviness, worry, anxiety, anything that feels heavy within your heart space, anything weighing on your heart, just let that. Chakra is all about love, of course. Love, being able to give as well as receive. Just moving any energy here, but also on your shoulders, down your arms, any tension or heaviness. That shoulder area. The color of our heart chakra is green, pink energy. The element is air. Physical, helping with that heart as well as the lungs. Allowing that space to be open and expansive, not constricted. Breathe, we're breathing in the new, we're breathing in life, vitality, energy for our body, our organs, our cells, our blood, our brain. exhale, we're releasing all the old stagnant energy, debris. Releasing any grief or sadness, any resentment. You might be having a hard time letting go of. And then helping on the back would be kind of the shoulder blades, which I like to call your angel wings there. If you hold any tension, chakras, they are from front to back, open front to back, all the way singing bowl. Beautiful green Tara. Compassion, love. Bring in the heart. heart tuning for. Some malachite, that heart chakra. Let's bring in some chrysoprase. Oh, this isn't chrysoprase. I just went blank. Chrysocolla. Close, but no cigar. That almost looks like a little heart there, doesn't it? And don't forget to drink water. All right, I'm going to move up to that throat. Chakra, your neck, your shoulders, any tension here, that high heart, which is right above, here's your heart, and then we have the high heart, which is turquoise, and we have the throat chakra, which is ocean blue. Energy between the heart, the high heart, and the throat to move effortlessly, helping us to speak our truth, express ourselves from the heart. Also, just relax your jaw, relax your shoulders, move those back and your neck, even support, maybe just Support your neck for a second and allow it just to area can get congested pretty easily. If we don't feel like we can, you know, say whatever it is we need to say, if we hold back a lot, you might feel that energy, you know, within your neck, but also within that heart space. Because our emotions are energy, emotions, energy in motion. So if we stuff or internalize how we're feeling down, and especially if we do it on a continuous, you know, basis where we're just constantly, especially the same emotion that can wants to move, wants to shift, so it can cause, you know, sensations within our body, tightness in our chest or in our throat or an energy healing just helps to release some of those. Also find too, you know, again, especially on this throat, it can also be the back of the neck, back here, because our chakras go all the way through, and sometimes I call it the back of the, it's the back of the chakra, or the back of that heart space, what's hidden way tucked away, way deep down inside. Maybe been buried for a while, or let's bring in the tuning fork. Throat chakra. Let's bring in. Helping us to express from our heart space freely whatever it is that we need. There can be a lot of fear energy associated with that throat chakra, the emotion of fear as well. Thank you. Because most of the time, you know, why is it that we may hold back? You know, is it fear of rejection? Is it fear of being dismissed or not heard? Was it fear of, you know, not wanting to hurt someone else's feelings? So if you think about it, there's a lot of that. Misunderstood. All right, I'm going to move to that third eye. Indigo in color. So just soften your brow, your jaw, your shoulders. Allow your eyes just to rest, not holding any tension. Notice just allowing your belly to be soft, your brows to be soft. Clearing energy from that headspace as well as those ears, our ear chakras. We have just that input, overstimulation, chatter, just relaxing that. Clearing all that away, allowing this energy to expand arguments or words that need to be let go of. Tension in your head, just let go of that. Our third eye chakra is indigo in color, midnight blue. It's about our intuition, clarity, being able to see clearly. Let's move to the back of the head here. Like if someone was kind of your fingers or you're holding, supporting that head. Any tension you hold in the back of your head. Let's do the third eye tuning fork. You can close your eyes and just listen, clearing any congestion there. Singing bowl for the third eye and crown. Mm-hmm. bring in some halite. Halite is one of the best crystals for anxiety, calming that down, soothing the mind, relaxing the mind. And with our intuition, in order to hear it clearly, we first have to allow the mind to be relaxed, at ease. And energy healing is good for that. Meditation, listening. I do guided meditations, Reiki infused. There's all sorts of amazing people on there. You can check it out. And then I will repost this to YouTube. So if you have found this helpful, you can go back and watch it at your convenience, at night, before bed, or if you're feeling stressed or overwhelmed. Once I post this, this will be 152. I have 152 lives, so a ton on there. All that is in my bio, as well as sessions in person or distance. They're all the same, but they're all different. Some more relaxing, some I talk a little more. It's just whatever I'm kind of channeling for the day, what people need. We're going to work on the top of the head, our crown. Excuse me. Crown chakra, which is purple, violet in color. And just allowing that headspace, that crown to open. And bringing in beautiful, like a waterfall of iridescent light flowing into the top of your head and moving down each chakra. Clearing, cleansing, releasing. Thank you. Healing touch is wonderful, used in a lot of hospitals. One of the hospitals I worked at, Cincinnati, did healing touch, a children's hospital. Healing touch is, you know, there's lots of different forms of energy work, energy healing, but the same concept, helping to balance, harmonize our ki, chi, prana, energy. See, I'm gonna bring in some beautiful amethyst. Looks like a crown. For the crown. Amethyst is wonderful for a calming, relaxing, soothing, great for sleep. This would be a really good crystal to have at your nightstand, by your bed. Not only is it very calming and soothing, but it's very high vibrational energy. This would be another good one for anxiety or stress. Bring in the crown, tuning fork, and just listen to the sound, the vibration. Crystalline, iridescent energy. to do one last tuning fork. This is the soul chakra, so above the crown, connecting us to that beautiful light, divine source energy. Let's go over each chakra. And again, I will repost this one to YouTube. All that info is in my bio. I'm also on Instagram. I post to my Instagram stories daily. I always post kind of a little message of the day on the story. Anything that I am a very visual person, things that I find inspiring. All right, let's go over the root, sacral, solar plexus, heart. Julie, thanks for being here. Sometimes it's just nice to receive, just to receive, and and so I'm glad that it made you feel lighter. We had some releases, and hopefully maybe today you might be able to just rest. I'm going to ground our energy. Thank you. serpentine. And again, I, because people always ask if I have a set, like, schedule, and I don't, I go on whenever I can, because I do work full time, so usually a couple times a week, 2 to 3 times, unless I have some type of, emergency or someone's sick. So you can always, if you miss the live, you can always find it on YouTube. Feeling in all this beautiful healing energy for your highest good, the rest of your day, your evening, and days ahead. And so it is. I'm going to go ahead and turn comments on. I do leave my comments off except for my subscribers during all my lives, and that's because I, when I'm working, I am channeling, and it helps me to stay present and focused, and then I always encourage my subscribers, anything that they're going through, anything that they need specific for me to work on, to let me know. So, and then I always turn the comments on at the end, most of the time if I have time. Sometimes I have to go really fast because I have a client or something, and then I can't. Oh, thank you. Yeah, you should work with beads. Be creative. Creative inspiration. You are welcome. And then make sure to drink lots of water, especially if you're here the whole time. Have a little snack. Thank you. What'd you say about the algorithm? Just got algorithm here, and I'm so, oh, good. I'm glad. Thanks for being here, Krista. Yeah, the algorithm, sometimes it takes a while. Ah, oh, you're welcome. From Fiji. Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Wow, I think you might be the first person from Fiji. Fiji, wow, I bet that is absolutely stunning. Why the feeling I need to cry? Oh, that's good. So sometimes with energy healing, well, a lot of times, but it helps to release things that we might be storing, emotions in our body that we're not even aware of, especially in that heart space. And, our emotions are energy and they want to move emotions, energy, emotions. So if you feel emotional, that's nice, that's good. Allow it and release it. Allow that energy to come out. Allow the tears instead of holding back. So it's just a release. And energy healing can do that. It can, but it's good. It's because a lot of times it's hard. We don't, it's hard to feel the feelings, or sometimes we have to move on. We have to, so if you do have that, allow it. It's a safe place, and a healing place just to let go. You're welcome. You're welcome, Ashley. If you feel really relaxed, if you feel like you could take a nap, that's good, because your body, we are so used to being in that fight, flight energy that feels like the norm. And so it's like a ball of rubber bands or twine, and then the energy healing helps our nervous system release and relax, allowing everything in our body to release and relax, allowing our mind to relax, allowing our breath, our heart rate to slow. And if you feel tired, sleep, take a nap. But I can't, hold on, I'm gonna have to put my glasses on here. And oh gosh, they're dirty, but let's see. But it's odd, my pet jumping spider really responded to your live. Oh my gosh, you have a jump. So animals love energy healing because they can feel it. All plants, animals respond. Your environment, babies, children, and animals especially. I was doing a live for a woman. She was, she needed to go out to her car to have like a quiet where she wasn't gonna be disturbed. It was a distance session, and after she said, she was relaxing, but she opened her eyes, and both of her cats were on the hood of the car staring in. So I thought that was really cool. It's like they just, or animals might, come in and fall asleep or be interested. Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. You might be the first jumping spider. I love that. Animals love it. I have one cat in particular who, like, she asks for it every morning. Oh, good. Oh yeah, you do healing touch on your dogs and cats. It's wonderful. They love it. Good evening from Germany. Oh, it's evening time there. Let's see. Would it be? I don't know how many hours are you ahead. Are you ahead 5 or 6? Is it like 6 or 7 there? You're welcome. Yeah, 6:44. All right, and 6:44 in France. Bonjour. New Brunswick. Let's see. I wonder if I've been there. I've been when I was a little girl. I've been to Germany, and it was so, I loved it. Just the, oh my gosh, the forest, the mountains, the, oh gosh, it was so beautiful. I'm in Kentucky. You're welcome. Aw, thank you, Monica. I appreciate that. I'm glad you liked it. Is that Anastasia? Sorry if I said that wrong. I can't. Athanasia. No, that didn't. It's not Anastasia, but Athanasia. Username. Ireland. Ooh, I've been to Dublin. I've been to Dublin and then we took the train and went Dublin and let's see, Galway, and we stayed it was a long time ago, backpacked. Stayed in Ashford Castle. But at the time it was crazy when I went to Ireland, it was winter, you know, we went and, it snowed. So everything closed down and, but my experience with Dublin was we flew in, I can't remember why. I mean, we didn't even have a cell phone. Like that's how long I had to use like a payphone to call like a hostel or something. And, we walked into a bar. It was like, it had to have been like, I don't know, it was really early. And there were so many people there. And someone was like already like getting sick in the bathroom from over drinking for a football match. I guess it would be a football match. And it was wild. And it was like, I was like, holy cow, what time is it? It's like 10 or something. It was neat. In England, Nigeria, I live near Canada. Ooh, nice. Dubai. Ooh, I almost. Let's see. Wait, I want to see that. Dubai. So grateful for your YouTube uploads. They have helped me so much with sleep. Good. I'm glad that they have. This one will be a nice one for sleep. Some of mine, I'm chatty or, you know, excited or have a lot of energy or I don't know, you know, so some, this one will be a nice one for rest. Dubai, I've heard Dubai is amazing. I accepted a position over in the Middle East, I'm probably saying it wrong, in, Qatar, there was a new, most of my profession, all of my profession really until now, I worked in children's hospitals. I was a child life specialist, and I took a position as a child life specialist for the new Sidra Women and Children's Hospital in Qatar. And they were in the process of building this like unbelievable hospital, and I did everything, and then the onboarding stopped because the hospital, it was taking longer than they expected for it to even open. I think I had been waiting a year or so, almost close to, and then we ended up moving somewhere else, and so I didn't get over there, but I always wondered, you know, it's always so interesting, what would my life be like had that, you know, everything. I mean, we were ready. We were ready to go. And I was like, we're going to just do it. This is once in a lifetime opportunity. And, you know, even if it's for a few years and the experience and it didn't happen, but a reason, always a reason. Havana, my girl dog has kidney failure. Can you help her with Reiki? Oh, is she with you? Is she laying there? I'll do some Reiki for, what's her name? Havana. Let's do some Reiki for Havana. Hi. Oh, I've been to... So my mom was a flight attendant. So I did get to travel a lot, because you got to travel for free, you know, and standby. It's not like you had, if it's a full flight, well, you don't get on. And so in college, I took advantage of that, and I would, did a couple trips with my friends, and we would backpack and stay in hostels and, take the train and just sleep on it. And Italy, went to Naples, but we didn't stay in Naples, we went to Capri, and that was so beautiful. Capri, the Blue Grotto. We didn't go inside it, like we saw the water reflecting from the cave, but I don't think we went all the way in the cave, because then the tide in the boat, I love traveling because I love meeting just the people and the culture and the food and the beauty and Italy, the people were kind they're kind everywhere, but they were very, come and sit, and, at the table, they were really and the food, oh my gosh, was so good. Everywhere people are kind. You all know, or those who follow me, I usually can't start talking about it, because then I get emotional and start crying. The most weird, bizarre thing, but I did a family trip to Cornwall, England, as I found out that's a portion, right, of where, but my ancestors from, and Isles of Scilly, and it was something else. It was like this, oh gosh, my heart, see, it just already like, oh. Never experienced anything like it, really. Hopefully I'll be able to go back one day. And the people there were so kind, and it was just amazing. And just the water and the rocks and the ruggedness and the beauty and the it's just so amazing. The energy was unbelievable. The energy, it was like the ley lines that lay underneath, and the ocean and the serpentine and black tourmaline, cliffs, and the ancient energy. Going to America, did you? Yes, isn't that, it is. It's like, yeah, we just, it's, I don't know, it like awakens something within us, doesn't it? Traveling, it awakens, stirs the soul. It awakens something. I definitely have a Druid priestess in my family. Thank you. Cornwall, Isles of Scilly, Ireland, Norway. So I have like kind of all that Celtic and English and Viking and. Did you say, did you say how long have I been on? Oh, yeah, I've been on for a really long time. Gosh, I've probably been on almost, I might have been on for almost 2 hours, maybe, or getting close to. I'm sorry, it's the end, but I will repost. I'd love to go back to Ireland because when I went, you know, I was like young and so, and we went, you know, so because it was cheap because it was in the winter probably. And I would love to go in the spring or summer and you're welcome. Sorry you missed it. It'll be on YouTube. It's a nice relaxing one, so it'll be good for evening. Short video you post about a panic attack. Oh, was it a Reiki video to help? You have to, like, I always like, you know, why do you think that is? Gosh, you know, when you, in spiritual times or awakenings, kind of when you're kind of really going inward into yourself, you know, you're really looking within. You're really in tune with what it is that you need and not focused so much on the outside world and pleasing others. And so within that, there needs you know, a time of kind of this reflection, this quietness, this hermit mode, this hibernation. And, you know, when you travel, you're experiencing so many different things. You know, you're experiencing new smells and food. You're experiencing new visuals and the environments and the people. And, yeah. And so it really gives you the opportunity just to take it all in, reflect, be vulnerable, you know, rely on yourself, self-reliance, confidence, doing the things that make you happy, not worrying about anything else. And there's no selfishness in that. It's just, that's really amazing that you want to do it by yourself. As you know, a lot of people, they might have fear. They might have fear around that, or not being able to be alone with themselves or find joy within themselves. So many times we want to be around people or do things or go or this person or surround ourselves because we have a hard time just being with us, with our thoughts, with our feelings. So I think that's amazing. And it allows you to be able to be open to meeting new people, you know, talking to people that maybe you wouldn't otherwise, or, you know, asking, connecting, if you choose, being okay being alone. I love that. Yeah. I'm sorry that you're struggling, and yeah, after a relationship that was abusive. And the aloneness, though, you know, it could be too. Sometimes it can feel even more painful or lonelier when you're in a relationship or with someone that doesn't reciprocate, you know? So think of it as just working on you, your time to heal, give yourself time. Look for support, kindness, most of all kindness to yourself, self-love, kindness to yourself, being gentle to yourself, loving yourself, or relearning to love yourself. Thank you. Yeah, I just got these. TikTok shop. Yeah, gosh, that's, yeah. TikTok shop. Yeah, that's one thing. It's like, oh, I need that. Oh, I need that. Oh, look at that. That's, oh, goodness. has been good, and I think I'm going to go ahead and get off, eat a little something. Thanks for everybody who is on today, and yeah, I will repost this if you missed it or just caught bits and pieces to YouTube. Probably be on later this evening. Let's see, what is today? Is today? I'll be back on this week. I don't know exactly what day. I'll have to take a look. And yeah, take good care of yourself. Eat a little something. Get something to drink. Relax, rest if you can. If you can't, I hope you have a good rest of your day and evening. And yeah, all right. Love you guys. And I'll see you soon. Bye.